While Congress continues to debate a new round of COVID relief money, one chunk of aid appears to be left on the chopping block, and that is funding for state and local governments. For how this development may affect cities across the country, I'm joined by two mayors on the front lines of the COVID fight. Nan Whaley, Democrat of Dayton, Ohio, and David Holt, Republican of Oklahoma City. We welcome both of you to the NewsHour. Thank you so much for joining us. Mayor Whaley, I'm going to start with you. How has COVID affected the people of Dayton? How has it affected your community?
Well, certainly it's very close to everybody, as we have seen a truly tremendous surge this past month in our community. So your friends, you know, everyone knows someone now that has passed away from the disease. And then it has really affected our schools, everyday life, really everything that you used to do, and even from the summer to the winter. And then, you know, while we're very hopeful and excited by the vaccine still hasn't made it to Dayton. So we are concerned about the economic recovery being pretty slow, even with the vaccine coming.
And Mayor Holt, Oklahoma City, with a population of, what, over 650,000. How has Oklahoma City been hit by this pandemic?
Well, like everybody, we've had, you know, serious levels of death that we've never experienced, at least I should say never, not probably since 1918. And, you know, we've had our healthcare system stretched to its limits. For several weeks now, we've had about 600 patients in the hospitals of Oklahoma City just for COVID-19, which is about a third of our capacity is just devoted to that. And then obviously there's the secondary economic effect that we've experienced. You know, I think other places have probably suffered more economically than Oklahoma City has, but it's not as if we've been immune from that. And it affects everything. And it certainly affects our city government functions as well. We're a government that's almost primarily and almost exclusively dependent on sales tax, which means that we get hit pretty fast when there's an economic downturn. So we, like many other governments, have had to tighten our belt as well. And that means fewer services for our residents.
And Mayor Whaley, what about the financial impact in Dayton? How has that been affected? How has it affected your ability to conduct the services that citizens need?
Well, when the COVID pandemic first hit, we quickly offered a volunteer separation plan for all of our employees. We have around a little over 1,800 employees. 102 of them took the buyout. So that made our the folks working at the city a lot less, and they've been doing a lot more during a pandemic with less people. That's simply not sustainable long-term because, you know, when people retire, they move in, you know, different parts of the organization get really, really hit in places that you just can't afford to keep on doing that. So that helped us through the 21 budget. We were hoping to get federal relief. If we don't see federal relief, we're prepared to not have a police class in 21, not have a fire class in 21. And you know, people retire every year, so that means that our levels will be lower coming in the 21 year.
And Mayor Holt, what about in Oklahoma City in terms of the, you touched on it a moment ago, but what has it meant? What kind of hit have you taken? And what difference could federal aid make one way or another?
Well, we're down about 5% in sales tax for this fiscal year. So we've had to freeze a lot of hiring that we had expected to make this year. We've certainly had to cut back programming, especially in our rec centers. You know, it's hard, you know, our first thing we want to protect are the people we have on staff now. But that means that we really, the worst impact is felt by our programming. And these are programs that people care about. But I do want to say something real quick, because I don't want Mayor Whaley to have to say this. 36 cities did get funding back in April and May from the original CARES Act. And we are blessed to be one of those cities here in Oklahoma City because we're over 500,000. But there are 3,000 cities across America over 10,000. There's 300 cities over 100,000. And only 36 of those got that funding. That funding had a lot of strings attached, and so we haven't necessarily been able to use it as much as we would have liked on our revenue shortfalls, but it has certainly given us a little bit of breathing room. And even though we benefited from that, I want to speak for Mayor Whaley and for other cities around the country, hundreds of them, thousands of them that never got that benefit. And that's why this package is so very important.
And Judy,
I appreciate your point. Go ahead, Mayor Whaley, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, David's right. You know, the smaller the town, the more this is felt. Because, you know, the smaller you are, you don't have the ability to really hold this loss. And so not getting in the federal relief packages affects small communities all across the country. And I don't really know what some of these smaller communities in Dayton are really going to do in the next quarter.
And just quickly, Mayor Holt, without that federal money making a difference.
Yeah. I mean, listen, cities and states are some of the biggest employers in any community. And the federal government has, rightfully so, supported many employers across our country in ways that have allowed them to retain their staff, pay their employees, and maintain their business. And our business is providing services to our residents, and we need that same support, and we need it across our cities, not just our biggest ones. Again, very grateful for that back in the spring here in Oklahoma City, but really want to see that same support given to cities and states across the United States.
Well, we need to hear this message, and we thank both of you for sharing your story with us. Mayor David Holt, Oklahoma City, Mayor Dan Whaley of Dayton, Ohio. Thank you.
Thank you, Judy.
Thank you, Judy.